Air-to-air refueling is one of the hardest things to do in DCS World, but setting up a tanker in the Mission Editor is very simple. Whether you need it for a mission or just training on your own time, this video should help you get everything ready. Hey guys, Emils here, and let's just get straight into it. When you're in the Mission Editor, you want to look on your left side and find the aircraft icon and click on it. It will open up a menu on the right side with all types of info, but for now, let's just click on the map and set the aircraft's starting point. Now, to see all available tankers, I will set the coalition to Combined Joint Task Forces, but you can set it to any country you are flying with and it will show you the appropriate tankers. Also, change the task to refueling so it shows you only tankers. The available tankers in DCS are the IL-78M for the Red Forces, the KC-135, which is a boom tanker, so that's for your F-16, F-15. There's the KC-130, a basket tanker for helicopters and planes like the Harrier and F-18, the KC-135 MPRS, which has a boom and baskets, but only the baskets are functional in DCS World. And we also have the S-3B tanker, which is a carrier-based basket tanker. There are also modded tankers like the KC-10, but your mileage with these can vary, and I recommend sticking to the base game tankers. Now that you have selected your tanker, we will set the altitude and speed it will be flying at. You could do it down here by the waypoint options. I usually set the altitude between 10,000 and 20,000, and the speed at around Mach 0.5, which is about 320 knots. You can vary this, but in the Harrier, this feels comfortable for me. You want to set the speed and altitude before you make the rest of the waypoints, so you don't have to edit each individually. So now we can create another waypoint. Make sure Add is selected down here, and then make one waypoint a bit further from your tanker. And then another one further away. So waypoint 1 to 2 will be the length of time you have to refuel. I need at least 10 minutes here, but you can change this as you like by just dragging this further away. And that would extend the time. Now make sure you change it to Edit and go to waypoint 1. We'll go to Advanced Waypoint Actions and add a task called Orbit. You'll want to make sure it is in racetrack, and you want to match the speed and altitude with the one you set here. So here I just have to change the speed. And now you're almost set, but we do need a way to find the tanker. So let's go to waypoint 0 and double click on Activate TACAN. By default, it's already here, but we have to set it up properly for it to work. So we want to go for channel mode to be Y for air to air. The channel you can set to whatever you'd like. I'll set mine to 17. And the call sign you can also change pretty much to whatever you like. I like matching it with the one the DCS gave it, so either Texaco, Arco, or Shell. So in this case, that would be Tex. The most important part here is under unit, you want to link it to your tanker, which in this case for me is Aerial 1-1. And that's the tanker setup. But there is one more thing you might want to turn on so you don't shoot the tanker out of the sky and commit fratricide when you're having a bad day of refueling. Go to where you would add a task at waypoint 0, press Add, go to Perform Command, scroll down this menu, and select Immortal. If the value box is checked, that means it is on, and you can rest assured that the tanker will be safe from your rage. I hope this short tutorial was helpful for you guys, and let me know if you want to see more tutorials in the Mission Editor by leaving a like on this video. Alright, that's it for me, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!